Welcome to Simon Barry's vlog. In today's vlog, I will discuss my favourite social media platform, as well as giving you business tips on how to get the best out of social media for your business. Let's take it away. Hello, my name's Simon Barry, and today I'm talking all things social media. So I'm going to go through what my favourite social media platform is, and let's go through each of them in turn and see what we can do. So you guys who may or may not know me rather well, I got into Snapchat probably about a year and a half ago, and I found it very, very helpful, supportive in terms of getting me into being able to be comfortable with talking to things like this, cameras, and you, dear viewer, and it really helped me. I've made some fantastic friends through Snapchat. I absolutely adore the platform, and it's got me into vlogging, which is pretty awesome. So now I'm on YouTube, now I'm all over the place, and you can find videos. And of course, I still love the Snapchat platform. But is it my favourite? No, it's not. Of course, there's others. There is Facebook, and Facebook is Facebook. It is the most populous social media network out there. It has billions of people on it. And I think it has its worth. I think most people, if they were to choose one social network, that's probably the one they choose, so they're probably on Facebook. I'm kind of on there because lots of friends and family are on there, but it's not my favourite. But I'm being a bit more active on it recently, certainly by engaging on the business side, so that's pretty good. So what else we got? We got Pinterest. Am I on Pinterest? Yes, I am on Pinterest. And I do like Pinterest, and those of you who follow me on Pinterest will know I have rather a lot of pins, and it's an interesting platform. I don't spend a lot of time there, but I quite like it. But it's not my favourite, certainly not my favourite. And what else is there? LinkedIn. What can I say about LinkedIn? If you're a business, it's great. LinkedIn has tried to update itself with the times. Its newsfeed is a bit more Facebooky, I suppose, and I'm not sure whether that's a good or a bad thing. People sharing more video and audio content and silly pictures, I don't necessarily fits in with a business platform. I'm not the hugest fan of it myself. I think it's okay. Again, I'm kind of on there because I have a digital CV and I've had business connections from it. What I have found of great value is being able to go in there and actually join groups, and joining groups actually on LinkedIn is pretty powerful. But I can see in the future how something like Facebook would overwhelm that. So is LinkedIn my favorite? Well, I think you can guess that. Absolutely not. So what have we covered? I think we've covered most of the big boys, haven't we? A few of the tiny ones. I am on Musical.ly as well. I don't quite get it. I think I'm way too old for that. But it is a bit of fun. It's aging up rapidly. I think it's kind of in the same bracket as Snapchat. I think it's pretty cool. I think it may have further relevance as it goes forward, as long as it keeps innovating. So Musical.ly gets a big thumbs up for me, but it is not my favourite social network. Instagram. Ah, Instagram has been a real interesting one. Great with video sharing, great with image sharing, a lot of artists, a lot of creatives. And if you were on there as a business and you construct anything or sell anything, have physical products to show, then you really need to be on Instagram. Instagram is the place to be. Amazing amount of users, lovely community, lots of great feedback. And of course, it's kind of been eating Snapchat's lunch. It's been taking the stories feature that Snapchat was so famous for and putting it into the Instagram application. Because of the millions of people using it, it's actually surpassed Snapchat in terms of how it's been done. And I actually really enjoy Instagram's stories feature. There are a number of innovations. For example, if you geotag your Instagram pictures, story things, people will be added automatically to a story of that local area, and that vastly increases the amount of viewers you get, which is pretty cool. It's got hashtagging. You can tag people with their username, which is pretty good, so you can tag your business or yourself or anybody else you want to shout out. They do live streaming as well, which is pretty mad. And they're also introducing live streaming where you can invite a guest on board, so someone who's watching you or maybe a business partner can go on board. So I would not discount Instagram if you're a business as something pretty awesome to do. I think it's up and coming, and more my attention is being drawn to Instagram because of the platform it is, but it's quite diverse and there's a lot going on. But is it my favourite? No, it is not my favourite. My favourite is Twitter. And I'll tell you a little bit about my Twitter story. I joined Twitter really, really, really early on. I love technology. I love trying new things. And this new startup out of Silicon Valley sounded pretty cool. This kind of micro blogging service. Nobody quite knew what the hell it was. Now I think arguably people still don't know what the hell it is. But I joined it and I could chat to Twitter developers. I could chat to people from Silicon Valley. I could chat to famous LA rappers. I could chat to VCs and investors and generally cool people. And there was a great etiquette. If you engage with someone, they'd be polite. They'd say thank you. If you followed someone, they would give you a personal thank you back. It was all very polite. You know, everyone followed each other back. It was a community and everyone talked. And I would read every single tweet. That sounds ludicrous now because there are millions of the things, but I read every single one. And whenever I logged in, I'd scroll right back until I went back, until I'd left, and I would read down, I'd go through, and I'd respond and engage with people. And it was great in terms of that social conversation. But something happened. Twitter became popular. This almost obscure little network where I used to go and chat with people all over the world became really popular. And it kind of changed, and businesses started to get involved, and marketing and people trying to sell stuff, and the volume of tweets went through the roof, and I found myself not being able to reach out, have the conversation with people that I wanted to. I found myself unable to read every single tweet, and that bothered me, and it shouldn't have done, but it did. And at the end of the day, I just kind of drifted away from the platform. I threw some content out there, but I didn't really like it. And then I kind of thought, yeah, this Twitter thing hasn't got too much relevance. It's going to be surpassed by other networks which are maybe more visual, maybe use video or images. But I was kind of drawn back into it, and I was drawn back into it by a business friend of mine, and he kind of said, well, come and check it out, I've got a community here. And I thought that community thing kind of set off a little light bulb in my head, and I thought, no, I will go and check it out. And I logged back in again, and of course I found the absolute mass of messages, and I found it overwhelming, and I think anybody does with Twitter. It is overwhelming. But if you search and you filter and you find your tribe, and the same is in business as well, if you find your potential customers in your niche around those hashtags or search terms that are relevant to what your customers use or relevant to what you're interested in, then you will find the diamonds in the rough, the gold nuggets, because believe me, there are gold nuggets in there. There are potential customers, there's partnerships, there's people you can find. It is brilliant. And I've now gone and through the power of search, which I didn't use before, which I was a bit of a silly billy for not using before, I've managed to find those diamonds in the rough, find those amazing people that think the same way as me, that want to do business the same way as me, that want to buy my products and services, and it's really, really helped me. So Twitter is absolutely a goldmine for me. Twitter is absolutely brilliant, and I now host a Twitter chat on a weekly basis, which I have talked about before, and I think for me, it has most of my attention. And there's brilliant conversations there that are very business focused. There are ones that are very personal focused. And I love the random element of it. It's quite random. You can dip into conversations. People are generally helpful and supportive. You get the odd troll, but generally it's pretty good and pretty helpful. So in a business, you know, I've told you what my personal favourite is. Yours may be LinkedIn or Facebook. I'd love to know. So as a business, if you're getting started, what should you be on? Should you be on every single social network you possibly can do? I would say absolutely not. I'd say pick two or three, but also pick the ones where the demographic, the customers are, the people you want to reach out for, your tribe is. It's no point in signing up for Snapchat if the demographic is completely wrong for you and the types of people who would buy for you just are not there. Same is with LinkedIn. LinkedIn has a typically older audience, and if you're selling to younger people, LinkedIn is not where you need to be. Facebook, I say, is pretty universal given there are billions of people on there, but again, you still need to be quite savvy and clever in terms of finding your audience. So pick two or three. Don't let social media control your life, because it is something you get sucked into in terms of time. And those of us, myself included, who do it as a day job, actually spend a lot of time on it. You don't have to spend a lot of time on it. So pick the ones that are relevant, and use those search functions, use those hashtags, those keywords, and actually find your tribe. And the most important thing, which I will leave you with, is the whole point of social. The whole point of social is to talk to people. The whole point of social is the fact that we have, and I'll have to put my coffee down because this is relevant, we have one mouth, but we have two ears and two eyes. So we need to be twice as observant and listening twice as much as we are talking. And that is as relevant in person as it is online as well. And I don't see any difference in terms of how you should treat people. You should treat people with the same kindness and respect as you do offline, as you do offline. Too many people want to just blast their message out and please buy my widget. It's not relevant. Engage, chat, listen, look, and then talk. And then that's absolutely relevant in terms of how you'll get on with your business and how you can have meaningful conversations. Because if you're earning that respect and that trust, and you're offering value and you're offering support, then people are far more likely to do business with you. And the beauty about social media is it's often easier to tell the people who are genuine and supportive and nice and kind than it is by the people who are just trying to make a quick buck. So that would be my top tip. Again, my favorite social media network was Twitter. Please tell me yours. I'd love to know. So that's it. That is my vlog. Again, I'm doing the Savvy Sexy Social SSS VEDA vlog every day in August by Amy Schmittauer. That basically means I'm going to deliver you guys a video every single day throughout August. And it is a challenge. But if you don't rise to these challenges, you never get anything done. Of course, I would love a subscribe. That really means a lot to me. And please smash that bell in the corner. Join my notification squad so any new fresh content can be delivered straight to you and you can get that value straight away. I really appreciate it. So any comments, questions, thoughts, or feelings in the comments, there's how to get in touch with me. And of course, you can give a comment below. I really appreciate it. So thank you very much, guys. And I will catch you on the next vlog.